Thank you. Osvaldo Goliath. This piece needs a little bit of an explanation. This was conceived as a concerto for Yo-Yo Ma, and it was inspired by the sky that Osvaldo Goliath saw in the summers at the Tanglewood Institute, hence the Spanish word azul, blue. And when he wrote it, he said he didn't want to write a virtuoso solo showcase. Instead, he wanted to trade that bombast for a more contemplative style of writing. He wrote a work that was not a concerto, but rather something in the sphere. He also wanted to evoke the majesty of certain Baroque adagios and recapture the presence, the ability of the late Baroque composers to suspend time without stopping motion in their music, and to achieve somehow for himself that special light-filled airness that one hears in a composer like Couperin. He describes the orchestra as being a quote-unquote antenna for the soloist, a collective body taking in and processing various musical energies, creating auras, halos around the cello's music. This ensemble you see in front of you is arranged in a very unique way, with each group of instruments having its own discrete function. The soloists, cello, accordion, percussion, sit in a semicircle around the conductor, just like a concerto grosso from the Baroque period. The strings are positioned in concentric symmetrical arcs. Violas are first, then second violins, then first violins, then cellos, and finally basses in the back of the stage. The rest of this ensemble is in smaller groups. We have horn one on this side of the stage. We have a group of woodwinds down stage right. We have the brass instruments up stage right, conceived as providing quote-unquote musical interference to the main proceedings. The part of the antenna receptive to a cosmic radio signal. And then a final group upstage left, the quote-unquote ringing instruments meant to stabilize the harmonic world, harp, celesta, and pitched percussion. In creating this unique sound, Goliath's aim is to establish an environment sympathetic to communal silence, where the music on stage ebbs and flows through emergence and submergence that suggest different levels of focus on the part of the listener. There are four movements connected without pause, evoking multiple styles: old world classical tradition, chamber music, synagogue chant, Yiddish klezmer, the innovations of tango from Astor Piazzolla, and Latin American folk music. Movement one is called Surferic Peace, is inspired by the line from Pablo Neruda, "I plunged a turbulent and tender hand to the most secret organs of the earth." It conjures our relationship as humans with a natural world as the earth breathes in and breathes out. Movement two, Silencio, is a Baroque adagio which revisits the form of a chaconne, a repeating bass line with melodic variations. Movement three, Transit, is a cadenza for all the solo instruments around me. It sounds a little bit like the Bach cello suites, but also intertwines world music like Yo-Yo Ma's Silk Road project. And finally, movement four, Jerusalem, explores the impact of Jerusalem as a spiritual center, that through our personal spirituality, we can deepen our serenity, our peace, and our joy. At the center of all this is our relationship with each other, the world, and the universe. At the end of Jerusalem, we have a double coda that Goliath describes as an explosion of all these ideas into the universe. And then finally, cosmic breathing, following this gigantic blast. All the worlds colliding and are tossed into the universe. Radio waves, electronics, harmonics, glissandos, flutter tongue. I was actually on the phone with Osvaldo Goliath, and he describes the ending as Louis Armstrong in the Milky Way. Sit back in, relax, and enjoy his performance.